do you have any thoughts on Wolfram's model, critiques, any, what do you find interesting, what do you find not interesting, convincing, not convincing?
I am not overexcited by the idea that a simple classical microscopical model could reproduce the complexity of the physics that we see.
Why do you call it a classical model? Because it's definite, the hypergraph is definite, or what?
It's classical in the sense that we can view this as evolution in time, and at each specific
steps,
moment,
yeah,
there are steps, the fundamental variables which have a unique value. So in that sense, it's classical. Quantum mechanics, variables don't have a specific value. I think that to reconstruct the complexity of quantum mechanics in full has not been done yet. I have not seen it yet. And I doubt that one could actually do it unless I see it in detail. There are aspects of quantum mechanics like those captured by Cochen's spectral theorem, or by the Berlin inequalities, which are very hard to reproduce this way, notoriously very hard to reproduce this way. So one might copy some aspect of quantum mechanics. I haven't seen the full prediction of quantum mechanics coming out yet.
What about for general relativity? I don't know if you've heard the claims or read the paper that the hypergraph model can reproduce. And you can tell me, just so you know, my naive assessment, I believe what they do is an ADM decomposition at some point. And so whenever I hear that, it to me means, okay, so you're foliating, so then you have a preferred time, and for some reason that I'm averse to that because space-time to me shouldn't be able, at least generically, is not able to be foliated. But I don't know if that's just my own personal taste, and I should, or if that's an actual argument against or for it. Like, I
this
don't
is
know.
Your personal taste, but it's also my personal taste. But it's not an argument, because if it was possible to derive all the theory from a completely different point of view, namely not the point of view of general covariance, not the point of view of Einstein, but from the point of view of existing or special preferred foliation, then okay, we would have to confront that. But once again, there's some aspect of general relativity which have been recovered. I tried to read some of the papers on the recovery of general relativity. You know, it's, if you have something geometrical and you go at large scale, general relativity has come out, it's not too hard to come out with the Einstein equations. But once again, this is not full general relativity yet. And if it is full general relativity, it would predict definitely corrections to general relativity, which we would be testable. Okay? So until I see this testing, namely that general relativity is factually wrong on some short scale, and we see the discrepancy, I would say, well, this is a more complicated way of saying the same story, which it's distinguishable and is based on different principles, which are not the ones which seem to be implemented in the world. Namely, in the world, it seems to be that there's no reference frame, as you say. There's no preferred foliation, as you say. So that's the kind of things we have learned from general relativity. So why do we have to give them up? You know, let's go to Copernicus once again. After Copernicus did his model, it seemed to work very well on something. One thing it did work very well is that if you make the other planets go around the sun, you understand why the other planets have a feature of their motion which have a period of 1 year, because they go around the sun, so of course they will. But the strongly counterintuitive things was the Earth move. So some people, and in particular Tycho Brahe, the greatest astronomer Kepler used his data for doing his work. Tycho Brahe came out with a system which is called the Tychonic system, the system of Tycho Brahe, which was intermediate between Copernicus
Ptolemaic.
And Ptolemy, which was that the Earth is the center of the universe. The Earth is fixed, so there's nothing counterintuitive. The Sun goes around, and all the other planets go around the Sun. Yeah, it's a brilliant idea, if you want, right? Okay, you get the cake and you eat it too. So you get the advantage of Copernicus without the conceptual difficulty of Copernicus. So in a sense, it was to try to recover the advantage of Copernican, staying with the old mind frame, which is the Earth is fixed. Okay? Is it coherent? Yes, it's coherent. Has it been historically useful? No. I mean, we would have never got to Newton or Kepler or Galileo and modern physics with that way. The point about Kepler was precisely that if we give up the Earth moving, if we get out of this mind frame of we are static, we have a better way of understanding the world. So Tycho was completely wrong scientifically. And of course, we recognize it completely wrong scientifically, right? So I think that when we have learned general relativity, or when we learn special relativity, of course we can, by being super smart like Tycho, arrange things that we stay with the old conceptual thing and recover the same thing with some technicalities. But we don't learn more about the world. We just hang on yourself to old thinking and don't accept the new thinking, which is the one that allows to go faster. The new thinking is just move. Forget that. Forget this intuition that my ground is not moving. So it's the same with this reconstruction of quantum mechanics from an underlying, basically classical system. I don't believe that is impossible. I haven't seen it yet, but suppose it's possible. But do we believe that this pushing them ahead is telling us that really, really nature in its death? It's like we thought yesterday. Come on. Nature in its death is like we think today, not like we thought yesterday. There's moves.
Is this what you, in your mind, in the back of your mind, perhaps, think of Lee Smolin's idea of time? Like, Lee, you are trying to
Yeah.
hold on. Yeah.
It's the same story. It's exactly the same story. So take the discovery seriously, right? What Einstein did when he did special relativity. There were these Maxwell equations that seemed to contradict Galilean relativity. Which one is wrong? Einstein's answer is neither. They're both right. Believe the physics, right? And when Einstein did general relativity, he took this idea of Maxwell of the fields. And he applied to gravity. So he believed the physics. He believed the new results that work. Those are empirically don't believe your intuition. Believe that it works.
If you enjoyed this Toe clipping, then the full video is linked in the description. You should also sign up for Toe Mail, which is again in the description and the pinned comment. You'll receive immediate access to all exclusive updates from the Theories of Everything podcast. It also helps me communicate directly with the core Toe community. You'll also receive my top 10 toes. Think of it as the intellectual version of Quentin Tarantino's obsession.